Hey there, fellow beauty finders. It's Mathias for Makeup, and I'm so excited you guys decided to click on today's First Impressions Friday. So in today's First Impressions Friday, I'm going to be breaking down the new Revlon Candid Photoready Foundation. Now, I actually spent some money and got this foundation in three different colors. I have this in 350, 430, and 440. I went to Ulta, I did some color matching, some swatching on my hand. For those of you who are following me on Patreon, that was one of the exclusive videos that only you got access to by being my loyalty monthly member. So yeah, learning how to color swatch when you go into a store is so important. So those are the kind of things that I will give to you as a loyalty monthly member on Patreon. So look down below in the description and find out more information about my Patreon page, where you can become a loyalty member for as little as $3 per month. So if you're interested in finding out if this Revlon Photoready Candid Foundation is pro makeup artist approved, then stay watching. If you are brand new to my YouTube channel, please make sure you're subscribed and your notifications are on so that you can get alerted when my two brand new videos come out every single week. But if you want, I will put a link to that full Get Ready With Me down below in the description, or I will actually put a little link right here. But stay tuned, don't tap on that right now. Okay, so today I'm going to be reviewing the Revlon Photoready Candid Natural Finish Foundation. Now, this also says anti-pollution foundation. What the hell is an anti-pollution foundation? I've never seen anti-pollution on anything other than a skincare, or maybe on a new electric vehicle? But anti-pollution, okay, all right, Candid, all right, whatever you say. Now, I picked up three colors, and I got the 350, which is natural tan, I got the 430, which is honey beige, and I got the 440, which is caramel. Now, I don't know about you, but my skin color can change pretty drastically compared to some other people that I have met and worked on in the past and clients that I meet. My skin can go from medium to like tan within 2 weeks. And that's either if I'm spending time in the sun and I'm not putting sunscreen on my chest or my arms or my legs, and I'm getting suntan on my body, so my foundation needs to go a little bit darker. And then in the wintertime, I can go a lot more fair. I wouldn't say porcelain or alabaster, but I would definitely say more of a like neutral light or neutral medium color. So I'm going to try out these three colors first. I'm going to color test them on the back of my hand. So looking at the three colors on my skin, I definitely feel like if I put the first one on, it would be too light. And I can always warm it up with a little bit of bronzer. I think if I put the second one on and it oxidized, it would be too dark. However, I'm tempted to just go with the medium color in the center because I know that my face is lighter than my body. See my arm? And then this color up here, I'm glad I got that because I can always mix that into the other two colors as my tanning routine gets a little bit more concurrent and I start doing self-tanner as the winter months come along. But I'm leaving this on just for a few minutes just to see if they do have a little bit of an oxidization,
is that a word?
Issue. Now, if I feel the foundation on the back of my hand, which is something I like to do because I'm a tactile, physical artist, I like tainting, I like touching, I like feeling. Sometimes warming up products with the tips of your fingers is the best way to get them to work for your skin. You shouldn't always just follow routines that you see people do on YouTube, especially when it's such a cold way of learning. You're not physically there in the room. You're not physically there to actually see the full 45 minute to an hour and a half long process that some of these YouTubers are doing when they're doing their own makeup. You're literally watching like a 10 to 20 minute long video, so you're not getting all the ins and outs. So what I like to do is I like to feel the foundation to give me an idea of how I want to apply this. This actually feels very creamy, very moist. The three colors together I actually like. This is like the three colors mixed together, so I might just start with that. I'm definitely seeing an oxidization issue. Is that correct? Let me know. I'm definitely seeing this one warm up. I don't know if you can see that on camera, but I'm seeing them warm up. So I'm gonna start with the lightest. And then if I need to warm it up, I will add a little bit of the other two. Probably not the third one, but definitely the second one. So I'm gonna start with 350. I'm gonna start with my ring finger, and I'm gonna take 350, which is the lightest of the three colors that I thought would work for me, and I'm gonna place that under my eye area and then pull down onto the high points of my cheekbones. And then take that also in the center of my forehead and down my nose. Little on my chin. Tip of the nose. And then a tiny bit across my eye. I'm going to take my Sigma Flat Angled Kabuki F88 brush. There's none left on my hand. I'm going to take what is on my face and try to blend it and buff it into my skin. I love this brush so much because of the angle of it. Do you see that little angle of it? So you can use it to tap the product, but then you can also use it to start dragging the product as well, up and away from the center. But because that little angle and that little kind of curve, you can go right underneath the eye. And the hairs are so soft, not pokey at all. Okay, so first impressions are that I used about 3 pumps on my hand right here. And I literally took the 3 pumps and smeared them and kind of like gave them a moment on 4 different parts of my face. So under each eye, onto my cheekbone, middle of the forehead, and the remainder on my chin. And then I tried to diffuse what was on my face out to the perimeters. And I don't have enough product to give me enough coverage. So this is kind of a really small bottle for having to use so much. How much is in here? This is a 0.75 fluid ounce. So it's not a full 1 ounce. Most foundations come in a 1 ounce bottle. But lucky for me, I do have that mixture on the back of my hand where I took the three colors and I mixed them together. So I'm gonna use what's left on the back of my hand, pick it up with the brush, and I'm gonna try and give myself some more coverage and some more color because this is a combination of the three. So it's gonna be a little bit deeper. I'm almost doing like a, almost like contouring with the foundation colors on the outside because it's a little bit warmer, the mixture. So my first impressions of this Revlon anti-pollution foundation are that it looks a little greasy on my face. I did do a lot of hydration before. However, when I took that e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer, is that what it's called? Poreless Putty Primer. I had it right. I didn't even need to pick it up. I thought that that was going to help kind of mattify me a little bit more. I would say it didn't really mattify me so much that it, so much as it kind of made my pores look a little smoother. The foundation is okay. I prefer something with a little bit more of a liquidy full coverage, whereas as opposed to this one is more of a thick creamy. I think this would be really good for somebody with dry skin. That's what my first impression is. I do want to give myself a little bit more coverage. I do want a little bit more for my areas where I feel like I need just a little bit of extra help. And I do still see my sun damage peeking through over here. But as far as an everyday foundation, it's actually nice. I mean, if you have pretty good skin and you aren't gonna be on camera, like I usually tend to put makeup on for, where you need perfect skin, you need a little bit more fuller coverage if you're gonna do photos or if you're gonna be on video. I think it's nice, I think it's okay. It's not settling into my pores. It's not the best foundation I have ever tried, but it's a nice foundation. I just don't know if 0.75 fluid ounces is enough for you, and I did have to use like 3 or 4 pumps, 5 or 6 pumps if you count what I used on the back of my hand to kind of finish it off around the perimeters. But let me know what you guys think down below. Let me know what your thoughts are on this foundation. Let me know what you think of how it looks, because I love getting your interaction and I love the community that I've created here on my YouTube channel with my fellow Beauty Finder Squad. Next, I am going to just fill in my brows just ever so slightly. I have started this new kind of semi-permanent brow routine, as you saw throughout the footage. I actually already have brows on. I have this amazing semi-permanent brow routine that just gets me like a week without having to fill in my brows. And if you become a Patreon member, you'll gain exclusive access to how I am doing that. So if you're interested in exclusive content like that, which is a little bit more specific, and I can't really put that on YouTube because no one's looking for that kind of a topic, I do specific educational vlogs only for my Patreon loyalty members. So look down below in the description for a link to my Patreon page, and you can become a member at either the $3, $5, $10, $25, $50, or even $100 reward tier. And there are many, many rewards to choose from, including face-to-face video chat tutoring lessons with me as a reward for being a loyal monthly member. And just kind of fill in just a little tiny bit where I feel like I want a little tiny bit more definition in the brow structure, although it's already been created using my semi-permanent technique. So as always, I would love to hear your comments and thoughts down below. Please do be interactive before you go. I love having you join my Beauty Finder squad here on my YouTube channel. If there's anything that you'd like to see more of, please do let me know. YouTube's algorithms have changed so much in the past year. There are people who are YouTube creators with 5 to 7 million subscribers, and their videos are only getting about 200 1,000 views. So that is a small, minuscule fraction of their subscription base actually watching their videos. So the more comments and interaction that we get, the more that YouTube will see that they should be showing our videos to more people. So I do love hearing your comments, even if it's just a hi, hello, thanks for the video, have a great day. I do appreciate it. Please, please, please do make sure you're subscribed to my channel and your notifications are on, and stick around because I got two more videos right here that I've already produced that I'd love for you to check out. I love you for joining my Beauty Finder squad, and I will see you soon. Bye for now.